So, अभी तक हमने इस वाले चैप्टर में क्या किया था? We had done all the laws, Boyle's law करा, हमने Charles law करा, Avogadro's law करा, Gay-Lussac law करा, फिर हमने Dalton law of partial pressure भी करा, ठीक है? Now, depending upon all these laws, even Graham's law of diffusion भी हमने करा था. ये सारे के सारे जो laws थे, they were experimentally verified and they were explained on the basis of practical evidences, right? But there was no theoretical evidence given for it. So Bernoulli was a scientist जिसने ये एक थ्योरी प्रेजेंट करी which was known as the kinetic theory of gases according to which he was able to explain all the laws theoretically, right? So कौन था साइंटिस्ट who gave the kinetic theory of gases? His name was Bernoulli. What was the postulates of this? When we talking of postulates, the first postulate was that all gases consist of identical particles and these identical particles may be atoms as in the case of inert gases or they may be molecules as in the case of rest of the gases. ठीक है, अब ये जो molecules होते हैं इनकी जो volume होती है that is said to be negligible. So it is said that the intermolecular spaces between the molecules is so large that the volume of the molecule is negligible. ठीक है, that is the molecule, the volume of the molecule is negligible as comparison to the total volume of the gas. जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगर हम ये वाला रूम कंसिडर कर रहे हैं एंड वी से दैट वी हैव वन मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ अ गैस, सो इफ यू टेकिंग द इंटायर वॉल्यूम ऑफ द रूम एंड यू टेकिंग द वॉल्यूम ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर मॉलिक्यूल, तो इसकी जो वॉल्यूम है वो निग्लिजिबल होगी एज कंपेयर टू द टोटल वॉल्यूम. ठीक है, देन थर्ड इट वॉज सीन दैट द मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ द गैस आर इन random motion, which means that the molecules they are moving and as a result of which they are colliding with one another, and also with the walls of the container. As the molecules they have a lot of spaces between them, they can easily vibrate not only about their mean positions but also in the surrounding areas. तो उसकी वजह से क्या होगा कि वो हिलते रहेंगे all the time, they are in motion. As a result of what they are going to collide with one another and they will also collide with the walls of the container जिसमें कि वो रखे गए हैं. This is the reason why they are going to exert what? They are going to exert pressure, right? Then number four, the molecules neither attract each other nor repel each other, right? So जो molecules है वो attract भी नहीं करेंगे because the forces of attraction between the molecules that is going to be negligible. The molecules they are very far apart from each other, so neither do they attract each other and उन पे forces of repulsion भी नहीं होगी because they are very far apart from each other. ठीक है, so this was another thing. Then number five, the pressure exerted by the molecules, that is directly proportional to number of collisions per unit time. Number of collisions per unit time per unit area. पर यूनिट टाइम पर यूनिट एरिया तो जितने ज्यादा कोलिजन्स होंगे पर यूनिट टाइम पर यूनिट एरिया उतना ही प्रेशर दैट इज गोइंग टू बी मोर. देन व्हेन वी आर सेइंग दैट द मॉलिक्यूल्स दे आर इन कांस्टेंट मोशन ऑब्वियसली दे आर गोइंग टू पोजेस सर्टेन काइनेटिक एनर्जी. तो काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ द मॉलिक्यूल्स दैट इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द टेम्परेचर. When the temperature increases, the motion of the molecules that is also going to increase and hence kinetic energy that will also increase. Okay? And then lastly, the forces of gravity has no effect on the speed of the molecules. Forces of gravity have no effect on the speed of the molecules, right? So these were the postulates. Let's just go through them once again. Number one, it said kinetic theory of gases said that all the gases, they consist of identical particles. These particles may be atoms or molecules. The intermolecular space between the molecule is so large that the volume of a molecule is negligible as compared to the total volume of the gas. Then number three, molecules, they are in random motion, colliding with one another and also colliding with the walls of the container. Hence, they exert pressure. Okay? Then number four, they neither attract each other because spaces jo hai uske beech mein itne zyada large hai ki forces of attraction negligible ho jate hai. In a similar manner, they neither repel each other. And then pressure that is directly proportional to number of collisions per unit time per unit area. Kinetic energy will be directly proportional to temperature because as temperature increases, the movement of the molecules is going to increase. Hence, kinetic energy will also increase. And finally, forces of gravity, they have no effect on the speed. Depending upon this, the kinetic energy of molecules of a gas that was formulated, which was known as the kinetic gas equation. So let's see what is the kinetic gas equation. Now, kinetic gas equation that is given as PV that is equal to 1 by 3 mm u square, right? This is the kinetic gas equation. Now, according to this, m that is going to be equal to mass of the molecule, right? M that is equal to mass of the molecule. Then we have V. We know what is V. That is the volume of the gas. P is going to be the pressure of the gas. N that is equal to number of molecules present. Number of molecules. And U square that is equal to root mean square velocity. ये जो root mean square velocity है, that is given as u square is equal to under root of u1 square plus u2 square plus u3 square divided by n. This is the root mean square velocity. ठीक है? Now when we are calculating the average kinetic energy of the molecules, let's see how do we calculate average kinetic energy of the molecules. This can be calculated by a kinetic gas equation. So according to the kinetic gas equation, what are we saying? That kinetic energy PV that is equal to what? 1 by 3 mm u square, right? It is seen that the kinetic energy Ek that is equal to, we know that kinetic energy is equal to 1 by 2 mv square. So over here we are calculating m in terms of number of molecules. So ye kya aa jayega 1 by 2 m n u square, where u square is again the root mean square velocity. So if we are looking at this equation over here, let's divide and multiply this equation by 2. So we are dividing and multiplying by 2 in order to derive the equation. So we have TV that is equal to 2 by 3 into 1 by 2 mn u square. ठीक है, so 1 by 2 mn u square that is equal to kinetic energy. Let's put the value over here. We will get PV is equal to 2 by 3 into Ek. Right? Now we know that according to the gas equation, PV that is equal to RT. So the above equation can now be written as 2 by 3 Ek that is equal to RT. ठीक है, या Ek that is equal to 3 by 2 RT. This is for one pole. This equation when we are writing, this is the equation for one mole. ठीक है, अगर हम यही equation for n number of moles करेंगे तो we will get Ek that is equal to 3 by 2 nRT. This is for n number of moles, and if we calculating it, kinetic energy for one molecule, in order to calculate the kinetic energy by one molecule, we are going to divide this equation by n naught. ठीक है, या अगर ये वन मोल के लिए है तो वन मॉलिक्यूल के लिए क्या आ जाएगा, वन डिवाइडेड बाय एवोगाड्रोस नंबर, सच दैट दिस इक्वेशन विल नाउ बिकम Ek दैट इज इक्वल टू 3 बाय 2 आर अपॉन एन ए टू टी. ठीक है, ये जो आर अपॉन एन ए है, वी नो दैट आर इज कॉन्स्टेंट, इट इज अ गैस कॉन्स्टेंट. Similarly, Na is also constant, which is the Avogadro's number. So, R upon Na, that is going to be represented as K, small k, where K that is equal to Boltzmann constant, such that this equation will now become Ek that is equal to 3 by 2 k into t, where k that is going to be equal to the Boltzmann constant. In certain books this is also represented by kb, so you can also write it as kb, Boltzmann constant. Right, now Maxwell Boltzmann, in fact what he did was he gave us the distribution of all the speeds of all the molecules which were present in the gas. And what he did, he plotted a graph between fraction of molecules and the speeds. That graphical representation that is known as Maxwell-Boltzmann's distribution of speeds. So let's study that in the next section. So what are we having over here? It's Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution of molecular speeds. So as I just told you, a graph was plotted between the fraction of molecules with a given speed. This is the fraction which can be represented by delta n upon na naught or na, and this is the molecular speeds which is given in centimeter per second. ओके, सो ग्राफ जो था दैट वाज प्लॉटेड टू एज लाइक दिस. नाउ द पीक व्हिच वी कैन सी ओवर हियर मोस्ट प्रोबेबल स्पीड, दैट इज द स्पीड विच मोस्ट ऑफ द फ्रैक्शन ऑफ द मॉलिक्यूल्स हैव. सो दिस इज नोन एज द मोस्ट प्रोबेबल स्पीड. ठीक है, when we are looking at this, there were three observations which could be derived from the Maxwell's distribution curves. The first was that the fraction of molecules having very high and very low speeds, fraction of molecules having very less. So you can see over here, this is the zero speed. So fraction of molecules having this speed is also very less. This is the highest speed, and fraction of molecules having the highest speed is also very less. Okay? So this was the first observation which was made. The second observation is that as the speed increases, the fraction of molecules having higher speeds also keeps on increasing. तो जैसे जैसे स्पीड इंक्रीज हुई है वैसे वैसे फ्रैक्शन ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स हैविंग हायर स्पीड इज ऑल्सो गोइंग टू इंक्रीज. सो दिस इज द सेकेंड ऑब्जर्वेशन, द फ्रैक्शन ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स हैविंग हायर स्पीड्स increases. ठीक है, till it reaches the peak and then it decreases. Okay, so यहां तक peak तक पहुंच के then it is going to decrease. Now, what is this speed over here? The speed which is corresponding to the peak, as I have just mentioned, that the peak represents the fraction of molecules having the, or the speed which is occupied by the maximum fraction of molecules, that is what this peak is going to signify. So that is why this is known as the most probable speed, MPS. Right? So this is known as the most probable speed. What is going to be the effect of temperature on this curve? It was seen that if this is the curve at temperature T1, okay, and when the temperature was increased, the graph was taken to be like this. Okay, so our most probable speed jo hai, that is going to increase. If this was the most probable speed at T1, this is going to be the most probable speed at T2. So the fractions having the maximum speed increases on increase in temperature. In this graph, T2, that is going to be greater than T1. Okay, so it is seen that at higher temperatures, the fraction of molecules have higher speeds. Fraction of molecules, they are going to have higher speed. ठीक है, so this is the Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution. According to this, जो भी एक गैस के मॉलिक्यूल्स होते हैं उनकी स्पीड्स को हम थ्री टाइप्स में डिवाइड करते हैं. सो लेट्स गो ऑन टू द काइंड ऑफ स्पीड्स और द टाइप्स ऑफ स्पीड्स व्हिच वी आर मेंशनिंग ओवर हियर. एज आई जस्ट सेड दैट देयर आर गोइंग टू बी देयर आर गोइंग टू बी थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ स्पीड्स. द फर्स्ट वन दैट इज नोन एज मोस्ट probable speed. ये जो मोस्ट प्रोबेबल स्पीड है दैट इज डिनोटेड बाय यूएमपी. ठीक है, व्हाट इज दिस? दिस इज द स्पीड पोजेस्ड बाय मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ molecules. It is the speed possessed by maximum number of molecules at a particular temperature. Temperature in this case has to be same, right? Now this UMP, it can be mathematically calculated as under root of 2RT upon m. This formula is important क्योंकि ये आपको आ जाता है इसका numerical कई बार. Okay? So UMP that is equal to under root of 2RT upon m, where R is the gas constant, T is the temperature, and m that is going to be equal to what? The molecular mass of the gas. Right? The second type of speed which we have that is known as the average speed, which is given by UAV. Average speed kya hui? It is the average of different speeds of different molecules. So if we have UAV, that will be given as speed of first, second, third, and so on, divided by total number of molecules, which is taken as m. Now in case we have different molecules are having different speeds. ठीक है, जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी से दैट एन मॉलिक्यूल्स हैव स्पीड इक्वल टू यू वन, सो वी हैव एन वन यू वन प्लस एन टू यू टू प्लस एन थ्री यू थ्री अपॉन टोटल नंबर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स विच विल बी गिवन एज एन वन प्लस एन टू प्लस एन थ्री. Right? Now in terms of temperature and molar masses, the U average that is given as under root of 8RT upon pi m. Right? Similarly, जैसे यहां पे हमने किया था, R is going to be the gas constant, T is the temperature, and m is going to be the molecular mass of the gas. ठीक है, फिर उसके बाद थर्ड हमारे पास आता है मोस्ट प्रोबेबल स्पीड. हमने कर लिया रूट मीन स्क्वायर स्पीड. रूट मीन स्क्वायर वेलोसिटी, दिस इज व्हाट वी हैव बीन डूइंग. सो यहां पे जो यूएमपी, दिस इज डिनोटेड बाय यूआरएमएस, रूट मीन स्क्वायर स्पीड. ठीक है, सो यू आर एम एस दैट विल बी गिवन एज अंडर रूट ऑफ यू वन का स्क्वायर प्लस यू टू का स्क्वायर प्लस यू थ्री का स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाय एन. Now, if in case, again in a similar manner, if u1 is the speed of n, one number of molecules, then this is now can be written as URMS that is equal to n1 u1 square plus divided by n1 plus n2 plus n3. ठीक है, सो दिस इज गोइंग टू बी यू आर एम एस. इन टर्म्स ऑफ डिस्टिंक्ट आर टी एंड एम, यू आर एम एस दैट इज गिवन एज अंडर रूट ऑफ 3RT upon M. Okay, so let's see the ratio of all the three speeds which we have spoken about over here. So we're talking of the ratio of U most probable speed is to U average is to U RMS. That can be written as what? It can be written as under root of 2RT upon M is to under root of 8RT upon pi M. ठीक है? Or is to under root of 3RT upon M. Okay. Now over here R and T and M, if they are constant, this can be written as under root of 2 is to under root of 8 upon pi is 2 under root of 3. ठीक है? So इसे जब हम लोग calculate करते हैं, then the ratio of these three that comes as 1 is to 1.128 is to 1.224. Okay, so when you're looking over here, you can see that root mean square velocity has the highest value. So we have U of RMS that is going to have a greater value than U of AB. This is the average speed greater than U of MP, that is the most probable speed. So this is one question which generally comes to you, right? What is the order of speeds of molecules? So आपकी जो root mean square velocity है वो सबसे ज़्यादा होती है, फिर उसके बाद average और फिर उसके बाद most probable speed, right? So this is all about the kinetic theory of gases. इसके बाद जो next हमारा topic है, that is going to be the Van der Waals equation, which we will do in the next lecture.